Hello, this is the Poltergeist 5000, and we're back with Paper Mario! And we're finally done! We're finally done our between episode, our between chapter faff. We got a bunch of new shit. We delivered a lot of badges. We got some items. We got some shit. That's good crap. It's gonna be cool. Gonna go. So let's go into the sewers, because we gotta go to the sewers. We're gonna get to see some new backgrounds in today's video. It's gonna be some new and exciting editing I have to do. Anyway, I feel like I'm missing a super block somewhere. Like, if I went back and talked to Mer Lovely, she'd be able to direct me to a couple of super blocks. Because I feel like going into Chapter 7, I should have more than half my party member, than half my party ultra ranked. But, I don't know, maybe not. What do I know? So, go in here, right? Wait, is that right? What am I doing? Oh, this would have been so much easier if I just gone into, this would have been so much easier if I had just gone in from Rip Cheeto's house. Fuck. Man, how could my timing have been that far off? Get the fuck out of my goddamn way! I've half a mind to start this video over just so I can go through, just so I can enter the sewers from the right direction. Because if I had entered the sewers from that blue house that goes right down to Rip Cheeto, we'd be literally right next to the door already. Yeah, fuck you. Okay, but anyway, we're here, so. And my nose is giving me hell as usual. Huh? Huh? Excuse me? What the fuck? I want the door open. How do I get the door to open? Let's go talk to Merlin. But first, I actually want to go over. To Mer Lovely and see if she has any information on where I can find a super block, or if there's actually four of them in chapter seven. I don't think there are, but anyway. If she doesn't have anything to say, I'll meet you guys back here. Otherwise, what am I doing? Oh, jeez. I totally forgot about that one. Okay, let's go do that real quick. Okay, yeah. Sorry, I guess we got a little more faffing to do, but it's just an area down here that I don't think I've even shown on camera in the LP yet. You can hop on Sushi, and there's actually a whole house. That pipe is where the super block is, but there's a star piece over here. I could have picked up a long time ago. I could have picked it up a long egg. Anyway, I would totally sleep down. Let's see what Goombara has to say about this area, because I would totally sleep down here. It's a room beneath the Toadtown Pond. I don't think anyone's been here for a long time. Yeah, and nobody ever will, because apparently nobody can swim without a cheap cheap, which is just like. Oh my gosh. How intoxicating. Okay, I want to get, yeah, I'll get Bombette. Bombette will be useful in, like, the early parts of Chapter 7, because I can't think of a single enemy in this chapter that flies in the air, except maybe a Magikoopa or two. Oh, wait, no, there's Swoopers. There's Swoopulas. That's right. Yeah. But even then, the first, like, 75% of this chapter is all ground enemies. Of course, watch me be wrong about that, too. Alright, let's go talk to Merlin, because I don't know where to go. I'm not sure why that door isn't opening. Oh, I think you actually do have to go talk to Merlin, because if you come in here, there'll be a ninji. Yeah.
Oh, it's you. You came at such a good time. There's a guest waiting for you.
What kind of voice do I give this guy?
Nice to meet you. I come from Starburn Valley. Starburn Valley is in the Shiver region, a chill place far to the north at the very end of the earth. Merl, who hails from there, said that he has something important to tell you, Mario.
Merl of Starburn Valley is my son, Mario. It seems she's calling for you. Who's the mother? If he's searching for you, you can be sure something important is afoot. You must go to Starburn Valley. Do not delay.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, please hurry. I will run ahead and take tidings of you to Merl.
I think somewhere deep below
Yes. Now we go down to the sewers. My total be, at least we get to cut out that trip over to Merlovely, except for showing the actual divination. Because she did end up having something important to say, something that I definitely would have forgotten about. Oh, my nose. I have a Halls, though, so it's... So I'm surviving. Sushi, where are you? You coming? Here you go. Now the door is open. And this door leads into a room. What is Goombario? I love having Goombario title these incidental rooms. And now it's really fucking cold! This tunnel is freezing! I should have worn a sweater. What do you think about someplace a bit warmer? Sorry, dude. But now it's time to upgrade another part of the room. Let's upgrade Bo. Sorry, Watt, I gotta upgrade the waifus. This is just the waifu upgrading episode. Of course, now we're out, and we're only 8 minutes in. So, and that's in the recording. That's gonna probably gonna be like 6 minutes in the actual episode. Because of that trip I have to cut out. Chapter 7! A Star Spirit on Ice! Brilliance! Sheer brilliance! I should see if I can get that clip. Oh my gosh.
Brilliance! Sheer brilliance!
And here we are! Welcome to Shiver City. I love this place. This place is so cute. This is Shiver City. It's usually completely covered with snow and ice. It's perfect for penguins, but it's a bit cold for me. You seem to be fine, though. How do you do it, Mario? I wear clothes. That part of the song right there where it does that loud, deep arpeggio or whatever reminds me of Spyro. You have a fourth degree card! Wow, you're strong. I wish I were that strong. I better train harder. I didn't know there were NPCs that actually commented on that. I saw a totally suspicious stranger wandering around just a short time ago. Oh, really? Well, how mysterious. Man, these houses remind me so much of the Thousand Year Door. Like, the way they're laid out. Shiver Mountain are both near here. But you'd better dress warmly if you plan on reaching them. Well... My overalls are super insulated fiber. So I wouldn't worry too much. Anyway, what do you say?
Yeah, hello! This is the northernmost burg, Shiver City! You come from hometown? Very, very far away, yeah? Welcome to Shiver City!
Oh, maybe I should have given that guy a Waka voice.
Starborn Valley? Oh, sure, go east from the city. But you have to be careful! I have it on good faith that there are lots of scary monsters between here and there. The thought makes me shiver. It seems like all I hear these days are frightening rumors, yeah? What's Shiver City coming to?
Okay. I saw this really bizarre guy around here the other day. He was shouting like, "Oh!" Or, "It's freezing!" And he was also going, "No! Mario!" What? Who was that nut? Yeah, no kidding. Like, he just yells. No, it's like that one. Oh my gosh, look at this fucking town! The Stone of the Northern Lands runs the Toadhouse. He was sent here from Princess Peach's castle. He was sent here. So it's like an actually organized effort? Oh, I didn't know that. That's it. Excuse me. It reminds me of the Game Grumps bit in Mario Maker where Aaron's like, "Oh no! Oh no! Oh no, Mario!" It's just like, because he's just like raging and trying to get the energy out as harmlessly as possible when he dies. Oh, man. Hey, it's a potato. Okay, so these potatoes, iced potatoes, are useful for a couple recipes, actually. So I'll probably try and... I'll put this away into storage. You can make potato salad, you can make frozen fries. I'm not sure how cooking a frozen potato makes frozen fries. I mean, because, like... You know, we'll put it in deep freeze, okay. How do the other people get it out? 40 coins for a life shroom? That's not bad. Do I still have a shooting star in reserve? Yes, I do. Here, let's take that. Let's just get it out of my storage. I don't need it. Am I still carrying around that repel gel? Yeah, I am. I guess I could hang on to it. What the hell? Dun, 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 dun. I think this goes out to the snow road. Nope, there's actually more area over here. Oh, hey, it's the three Toad sisters. One of the castle maids. Seeing as castle maids, it's a holiday. Oh, yeah. Well, skiing's nice, too, but not when a monster's loose. It's scary out in the snow, so city skating, you'll go. Yeah, yeah. Or something, I don't know. Henlo. Whoosh! It's a hedgehog! Get the broom! Kish! British! Okay, anyway. I really love sliding around in the snow. Pingy, pangy, pingy, pong! Snow was falling all day long. Skater, spinner, sing a song. Man, so happy! Oh my gosh! Dude! Wave vaunts? What? I think I better practice. Are you crazy? What? You got a song in your heart, sir. A horrible monster. There must be some sort of monstrous character around here. Name that game. I wish there were no monsters. I'm on alert because a stranger appeared in the city, so I can't let you pass without permission from the mayor. Aren't I the stranger? Nobody can get in because some careless guard managed to lose the key to the door. Actually, I'm the one who lost it. I had it just a little while ago. You stupid. Was off from the city. Very mysterious place. Yeah, because I guess Star Boulevard is broken. I do have I Spy on, so I won't miss any star pieces. Henlo. I'm the city guard around here. I've been missing any report of a suspicious character wandering around the city. You're not him, are you? No. No, definitely not. It's an empty house. That's scary. Why is it empty? That's weird. I think it might be important for part of the quest we have to do here before we can leave. Yeah, because we can't even really... I mean, I guess this is kind of like in the beginning of chapter 7 of Paper Mario 2, where, like, it also doesn't feel like the beginning until you get, like, a quarter of the way into the chapter. Anyway.
Then let's go to the question! Question. How many buildings are there in Koopa Village?
Six? Yeah. There's three on each screen.
Correct! Congratulations! Here's your star piece! We've done it to 12 questions so far. Good luck next time! So long! Farewell! Till we meet again!
So glad. Glad, glad, glad.
Pingy, pingy, penguin, pop, fill the rhythm, stop and pop, do the penguin, pangy, penguin.
Are you guys are on Minute Maid or something? Good lord! I ain't never seen a happier pang fish. What? Whoa! What's up here? Is this actually like a thing that's necessary to do? Oh, I can go in here. Hey, it's Goombario? What the hell? How'd you get in there? How'd you get down into the corner? Oh, it's Attack FXE. Oh, I forgot about that. Is that the last one? I know I only have four. I think I might have missed one. Where's the last Attack FXE, Attack FX badge? Excuse me. Hear you. That's the name of the person who, manages this shrine. I couldn't remember it the other day. Attack FX. Oh. from Pop Diva in Toad Town. I gotta do that side quest. I don't know how to do that side quest. Like, I talked to the lyricist and the guy in the desert who has the who does music, and they didn't have, and there was like, and there was no, fucking Reaper. Yeah, that's a, it's a Yoshi. It's a Yosh's. Yeah, I did the, I talked to both the lyricist and the melody dude, but they didn't give me anything. A really shady individual came to the city recently. He was screaming at the top of his lungs and running around. It was really odd. I think something strange going on in our peaceful city. They're giving us a lot of advance warning for this character appearing. Did I ever talk to the penguin in here?
Never talked to the penguin.
For a shaved ice cream, strawberry flavor, maybe watermelon, or my personal favorite, tangy tangerine. Oh, I love frozen treats. You're a penguin. Would you? I thought, what do penguins eat? This never occurred to me until right now. I have no idea what penguins eat. Anyway. Oh man, look at that. Look at that zest frappe on the table. You should be too flighty. What is this, problem sleuth? Oh, man. We have a guest. Welcome, you poor man. You must be freezing. If you'd like to see my husband, he's in the other room. Please go right in. Okay. What could possibly go wrong? Oh, my God! He's dead! No reply. Mayor Penguin's body doesn't budge an inch. What's this? He has a memo in his hand that says, Herringway. Darling, would you like a cup of tea? Excuse me. Oh, dear, you know you'll catch a cold if you sleep there. Oh! No! Oh, no. Oh, jeez. Anybody! My husband is dead! He's been murdered! It's a penguin murder mystery! Oh, for the love of crap! What the hell? What's going on here, madam? Just calm down now. You need to speak slowly so I can get to the bottom of this. Oh, jeez, it's the green. My husband is dead! Look at him lying there! Oh, my darling husband, somebody clipped his flippers! That floppy walk animation. By Puffin, you're right! The mayor's been murdered! This is like a mystery novel, except it's real! How tragic! But madam, if I may ask, who on earth could have reason to put this penguin on ice? Him! Right there! That man with the suspicious mustache! I told him not to come into the house, but he barged right in! My husband was alive right until this man showed up! Dude! 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 Hey, you! Mustache! Are you listening? This girl is accusing you. What do you say for yourself? Don't try to play ignorant with me, buddy. I'm a professional. We got a witness here. We don't have shit! Yes, that's right! He did it in cold blood! I saw it with my own eyes! Ugh, brother. Ugh. So you're sticking to your story, claiming you're not the culprit. What's your problem? You don't actually think Mario did it, do you? If you're telling the truth, then we're dealing with a backroom murder case. Oh, I never trained for this. A backroom murder case. A high-ranking penguin slain! How could such a horrible plot twist hit our beautiful city? You, Mr. Mustache, once more for the record, you swear you didn't do this?
Excuse me.
Okay, I think I believe you. But this means we have to find the true murderer. Ah, perfect! I'll give you a chance. Since you claim that you're not the guilty party, then you must bring me the murderer yourself! If you do that, I'll believe you. It's the only way. Okay. All right, off with you. You haven't proved that you're innocent yet, so I must forbid you to leave the city. Oh, jeez. Okay, well, here we go. We got a mystery on our hands, folks. Oh, we're all crowding around. Let me go save. I'm gonna end this episode. We'll do this in the next episode. I kind of want to, like, go back and, like, actually... Oh, jeez, what the hell? Am I being too rude? Sorry. Anyway, yeah. We'll solve this penguin mystery murder next time, but for now, I think I'm actually gonna go back and see what the other party members say when Mario gets accused, because I didn't expect Goombario to talk in that cutscene. I when you saw me open up my party member menu, I almost switched to Bo because I thought she would be more fitting for like a noir-style murder mystery, but I didn't expect the partners to say anything, so I didn't bother. So now I'm gonna go back and try that. You know, like, let me try that. Name that game. Okay, here's Cooper. Are you crazy? Do you really think Mario would do something like that? You tell that asshole, man. Jeez. Bombette? Don't be ridiculous. Mario didn't do it. Well, okay. A bit plain. Paracarry? Mario didn't do it. He's obviously innocent. Hey, you tell that asshole. Lady Bo. I was with him the whole time. I swear on my own grave, Mario's innocent. There, see, there's a little bit more flavor. So you guys be taking notes from Lady Bo here. Tell you what, man. And what?
Mario, didn't do it. It's mean that you're treating him like he's a bad guy, even though there's no, evidence.
You tell that asshole. You tell that asshole.
You tell those motherfucking assholes, you tell those assholes right now, you don't talk to my Mario like that.
I forgot to clap, man. Dang it. Alright, how about world-weary sushi? Or well-traveled. Hey, use your head. Do you really think Mario's capable of such a thing? Think about it. Yeah. Yeah. Sushi to the rescue with smart shit to say, as usual. And Lackalester. Here we go. What? Are you nuts, man? Mario's not a murderer. That's completely ridiculous. Yeah. You tell him. I don't know how to end this now.